Hello everyone, Moo here with part 8 of the I Am Setsuna walkthrough. We haven't really made too much progress from part 7. We are still trying to find that monster child that is necessary for the Magic Consortium individual to provide us with the potion or whatever cure he has for the knight leader, whose name I can't really remember right now. So we are in pursuit of that one particular item here, and hopefully we'll be able to get it. Interesting. I thought for sure the cyclone attack would totally kill these things. Feisty penguins.
エクソンの脅しだぜ。負けるわけにはいかないんでね。これぐらいでやられる俺じゃないぜ。
Okay, we're gonna head back to town after this because I want to run through and talk to everyone again. I don't know what's going on here, but we're not really getting anywhere, so there must be something we've missed. We're gonna go straight to the Magic Consortium guy and sort things out with him and see if there's any further clues. What? When did we pick that up? Alright, my bad. This dude's up to no good. He probably gave us a placebo. But nonetheless, we require him to sell all of the stuff we picked up, so let's do that right now. And what other things can we obtain here? Berserker, that's new. Yeah, we want that. Fire shield, all that stuff we already had. Fire 2, we already got one of those. That's fine, yep. Yep, nothing new. Oh, wait. I thought I saw a prayer 2 there. Nope, that's cure 2. We already got that. Okay, let's sort things out with Julianne. Hopefully that wasn't a trick from the Magic Consortium. Doesn't appear to be the case, as we are able to enter the house now, so. Remember, kid, you promised. Pretty sharp. Julianne knows us very well. Even if by intuition alone. Okay, well, it's all the talk we can do here. I do want to quickly check again for some food recipes. Hopefully there's something for us here. There we go. Now we can give it to the chef, and then he will store that recipe for us for the rest of the game. Wrong place. My bad. Let's see if this guy has any new weapons for us. Nope. give it to this guy. Let's see what it does. A crunchy casserole with a creamy filling. It boosts the amount of experience earned, a number of drops, and magical defense powers. Okay, pretty good. But nothing amazing, so we're not going to buy any more of that. We already know where we can go if we want to grind experience. But for now, let's just go with our guide and cross the waters. Okay, sure, yeah. Interesting. Sweet, we picked up another team member. I wonder if everything's gonna be okay leaving that sneaky old man in charge while she's away, though. Lilas is probably like, oh, thank God someone got me off the hook. I didn't want to be the guy to these guys. Oh, she's only level 17. What is this? Let's see if we can buy some stuff for her at least. Let's swap her out with talismans. Let's see what kind of talisman we can give her. Actually, let's see what she comes with to begin with. So she doesn't have much stuff. Let's give her a real talisman here. What do we have that we can give her? Let's give her this one. Oops. And what does she have here? She's got... What can we give her? Rising... Wait, that's an S. Let's put that in the S slot and save the... Soul Rage raises momentum power to its limits. Okay, yep, that's good. What do we have for A that we can put? Well, she is a magic-based person, so. I'll have to do for now. Let's head out. Actually, before we head out, my bad, let's see if the Magic Consortium guy can create some Sprite Knight just for her so we can boost up her power a little bit. There we go, Julienne. Precise thrust. Ice. And frost. Everything else we already have, okay, so Berserk is good, Rising Revere. Let's go with Precise Thrust instead. Alright, this is better. I think those two, Sprite Knight will do a little bit better than the ones we initially equipped. So, let's head forth and see where the story takes us now. And let's... Does anyone need healing? Nope, not really. Let's give our friend Endear some mana here, and then let's save as well. And now we can resume our journey once again. But before that, has this barrier been lifted? No, it has not, but we will grab that food material. And another one here. I think we got quite a few of those hermit gingers while we were trying to figure out exactly where we needed to get that material for her cure. Can we jump over here? No. Being only level 17, she should be able to level up really quickly here with our core team basically one-shotting everything. Okay, here we go. Hopefully she'll be able to take us across. She obviously has special powers, people. Nice, we're mowing down these easy enemies without much issue. That spell is so nice, but the problem with that one is it costs so much mana. It's not very cost efficient. Cyclone should be enough since it's just two enemies. Actually, we'll do that instead. Ooh, mid-ethers. I wonder if they restore more MP than the regular ones. They probably do. I mean, what else could they possibly do? Let's find out, actually. Yeah. Let's see what jump does. I'm quite curious. Oh wow. Not the most useful skill, but sure. She spends like two turns up in the air. I don't know how useful that's supposed to be, but of course, another locked chest. No worries. Okay, before we go that way, let's see what we have over on this side. Okay, so just two groups of monsters, no real clues. We're just gonna use Cyclone on these guys. Take care of them real quick. Nice. Got an upgrade for our friend Kier. Kinda weak. That's more like it. Anything around here? Oh, there's a material there. Antique indigo ring. That doesn't sound like something you'd want to put in a meal, but okay. looks like we are going to come up upon a boss here real quick, so let's save. And is he up there or down here or oh there's a box there, okay. That's a nice skill, but it didn't really do too much. Grab this crate over here. Blood Pact. What kind of talisman is that? Momentum effect and support bonus. That's actually a pretty good one because you do want to get those momentum effects maxed out as much as you can. It's going to make a significant difference. But for now, let's head up here and does look like there's a big mother penguin there. Oh, that did quite a bit of damage, actually.
Yoshi.
This thing is not really fighting back, so there's no reason to do anything in particular. Like, it basically was a punching bag. A penguin-shaped punching bag, which is fine with us. We were able to get quite a bit of experience out of that thing. Eternity, okay. More materials. And yet another material here. What cave is this? Should we go in here? Oh, this one's open. Okay, let's save first, just in case. And we should also use a tent as well, just to replenish our mana and HP. Always a good idea to save before going into a new area. You never know what kind of evil creatures are waiting for you. Old man's hearing things. Sweet. We managed to get four of these for Cyclone. Awesome. I think either 9 or 10 is the maximum, so we're definitely making good progress. I don't think we're actually that far into the game, given that these RPGs tend to be at least 30, 40 hours in length. This one's supposed to be a bit shorter though, but I guess we'll find out. Nice.
Nice.
A weapon upgrade, and a very nice one at that. We will definitely take that. Is that all there is in these ruins, or oh, there's a path down this way. Before we go left, let's go down here and see what kind of creatures and or treasure we can find. Oh, Counter-Strike. What is this? Dying power support bonus. Interesting. I'm not quite sure what dying power means, but it probably means that as you take more damage, you do more of something. Essentially, you become stronger the closer you are to death. We don't need momentum to crush such weak adversaries. Broken Indigo Necklace, okay. Before we go that way, let's see what's here. Oh, another one of those chests we can't open. I'm not even gonna try anymore. Well, that was a waste. Okay, let's check down this way first. That should do quite a bit of damage. And they can just clean up with regular attacks here. Yeah. You can momentum lock him all you want. Okay. I sure hope there's a way to teleport outside of these, whatever this is, some kind of cave or ruin. Because going back through all of these levels is going to be a pain in the ass. How dare you fight back? You shall be punished. Oh, there's something here. Interesting. We've entered some kind of a alternate dimension or dream world. This guy's got a sense of humor. I guess we'll just run straight. I don't know what the... Yeah, there's no way to go side to side, so... Straight it is. So Nadir was going to be married. We're learning quite a bit about him. That's really sad. I think he lost everybody when he was on his mission to the last stand. So we get to learn exactly what happened. So the previous sacrifice was named Nanase, and it seemed like she became sick and passed away before they were able to complete her sacrificial pilgrimage. That's brutal. Keep fighting the deer, don't fall for these tricks. Wow, we learned what truly happened to Nadir in his past. What? Setsuna is his daughter? This is absolutely brutal. As a father, he has to escort his daughter to her own sacrifice. Yep, we now know everything. Why? Wow. That was very sad. Let's level up Julien some more. She is far behind everyone else. And these monsters do not really pose much of a threat. Wow, we're really getting close to maxing this thing out. Magic seal, we'll check out that stuff later. So we can't activate this one until we probably activate the rest of these. I'm hoping there's a save point soon because I would like to save before we lose any progress. And also, I think we are reaching that point where part 8 of the series can be completed and we can start on part 9. Okay, here's a save point. So yes, we will save. And that does it for part 8 of the walkthrough. Thank you guys so much for watching. This was a really important part. We found out a lot about Nadir, his past, and the most shocking of all, that Setsuna is his daughter of all things. And that is just brutal. But thank you guys so much for watching. Stay tuned for part 9. And I'll see you guys soon.